Alright, hey everyone, this is stage two of the tour. Let's see if my phone survives, the battery's getting nice and low. Just give me 1 second. Anyways, yeah, so today is stage two. So this France course, I haven't raced it before, and I haven't raced this one before, and I just looked at some live streams, like at Labrack's live stream yesterday, just to see, get some idea of what's going on. And it looks like there's very flat kind of lead-in, and then one pretty fast climb in it. The climb looks like it's about 4.5 minutes. Average 4 or 5%. It looks like it's decently quick speeds though, going up it. That's what Ed was saying yesterday, that like, it doesn't really favor kind of the lightweight climbers. This course in general, it's more like a power climber. So, one of the guys that's in this race, Lionel Bujesen, He was actually number one ranked swifter in the world. And I think this course suits him very, very well. It's like right in his wheelhouse type of a climb. Like, just, it's going to be just big power. He'll be putting 500, easily 500 watts or something up it, I think. I think he's 70-something kilos, so... Yeah, I think maybe 500 watts, something like that. What would that be? Close to 500, maybe high, mid to high fours, I would think. So on the first, my game plan is, because I always like to have somewhat of a strategy, is first time up it, I'm going to ride kind of threshold. Assuming I don't get dropped at that. I don't think I should, because, like I said, it's pretty high speed on that climb. And it'll be a big group going into it. So I can't see me getting dropped at, like, 6 watts per kilo. So I'll try to ride the first, like I said, like, 350, 360. 60 kilos right now. So 360, I guess. And I don't think that'll get me... I don't think I'll be dropped at 6 watts per kilo for 4.5 minutes. I just can't see that happening. With such a big group, I mean, going into it. So such a high draft effect. And then the second time up, I'll try to kind of emerge from the group. Legs feel okay right now, I'd say. I just came back from a run. I always find doing just a 6-mile run, nothing insane. And I always find going on the bike after the run, your legs kind of feel a little funny to start. And then hopefully they settle down. It's the same thing bike to run, I guess. Like, the transition period is difficult. Alrighty. Let's stop this. Save. What are you talking about? What the hell this watch is talking about? It thinks it knows me. It thinks it gives me recommendations. Who are you? Like, easy effort recommended. What are you talking about? I'm at the end of a recovery week. I think a hard effort's recommended. That's what I think. Anyways, music going on. Hope you enjoy. Hope this computer is running decent today, decently quickly, as I've installed some new stuff on it. Warcraft, that is. Been playing a lot of it. Getting good. Getting good again. Feel like the good old days. Just starting to rip. Alright. Start picking it up. So Lionel Bouyesen, like I said, from Belgium, is the guy we're kind of keeping a bit of an eye on. Just had a power dropout. It's not good. There's a brake. Shit. Oh my god, my heart rate's so high. Coming off a full recovery week. What the hell? 185. (clears throat) 321 watts through 5. So 5.33. It's pretty decent. Seems like it's slowing ever so slightly. Yep, my heart rate is still staying up there. Went like a banshee. Hey, that's it. Or maybe it's the recovery week. Wasn't as helpful as I thought. Heart rate is jacked. First time we're in the 160s, oh boy. Chilling now. I mean, it doesn't actually feel that hard, but... Matthew Sharp's in this, too. He's a short course guy, triathlete. At the Super League and stuff. Wow, we are flying. If that heart rate's right, then when we get to the hill, I think it's going to be a peak 5-minute heart rate. I don't know if that's good or bad. I don't really train my heart rate at all. I just kind of use it kind of to look at it and be like, oh, that's interesting. It's high today, or it's, wow, it's really low today. Like, I really don't train by it in any way, shape, or form. It's just an extra number. I figure more numbers, the better. They could tell some things, like, in the same environment or something like that, like, they could tell, you know, give you some indication of dehydration, cardiac drip. Whew. First 10 minutes, 300. 5 watts per kilo. I believe the hill comes at about 17K. Pretty coarse if it wasn't for the lagging. Another dropout. Uh-oh. What the hell's going on? 10K in less than 12. Wow. Fast. $2.95 through 15. This isn't the actual climb. It's a little bump before it. Oh, maybe I should have went with the disc. One of the high speed races I've been in. This is insane. We're going like 50k an hour. Average. Through 20 minutes pretty much. I mean, the power kind of reflects that. I'm at 5 watts per kilo through 20 minutes in a group. And I haven't seen the front. Like, I haven't been in the wind all day so far. So it's taking 5 watts per kilo to just hang on a wheel. In Ed Lavrak's race, it was very similar. It's like steady for the first lap, and then it really calmed down after the climb. Get into it now. Get into the first little climb. First climb. The only climb on the first lap. That's a good stop. I'm gonna puke. Now recovery week, I tell ya. Hard coming off of it. I'm afraid to super talk because I just saw Lionel got almost spat off the bat when he did so. I don't think it's steep enough. For the first lap. Looks like we got a group of about 7. Legs felt pretty good on the climb. It just, the aerobic system wasn't as good. I felt like I was working really hard. I'm gonna see if I can try to save the aero all the way to the end. Because as you can see, it's a fast hit into the sprint. Why are we still pressing? I don't know. Holy moly. Calm down, everyone. I think the group behind will catch us. I'm okay with that. I'm not gonna pull on flat roads. That's not like 60 kilograms. I'm not gonna drive a train on a flat road. I know that sounds kind of bad that I'm not contributing, but I don't really mind if the other group catches us. We'll drop them again on the climb, just the same. So, it's just a useless waste of energy if I sit on the front. Just to what, keep them away? I'm not worried about them. Work with your strengths. That's basically what I'm saying. I'm a climber. I'm not gonna TT on the front here. Team time trial here. Let the big guys do that. My calf is cramping again. Same one, left calf. Here they come. Man, I'm so cramped up. I don't know what's going on. Second time in a row. I am sweating like crazy. Same calf though, that's what's kind of weird. Left calf both times. But I feel like my head is hot. I'm very hot. Holy moly, I'm dripping. Excuse me. It's killing me. Yeah, I should have put the disc on. That would have been good. The climb's so fast. I even see my heart rate under 170. This is... I don't know. It probably is just the heat. I am, like I said, just burning. Like I can feel it on the top of my head kind of thing. Like just heat coming off of it. Funny, very similar race to Ed's. First lap was like 5 watts, second lap 4. Uh-oh. Guys, I got not much left. My legs just feels too hard for the power right now. We'll see, but I don't know. Stop complaining. Still in it. Still in it. Don't give up. Let's go. Just focus. Jeez. I just... terrible. Really good, like, effort all around, but when I... fortunately, the mouse times out on the computer. And when I went to... you saw that. When I went to go hit the power up, I lost like 2 meters, and that was, I actually don't know what place I came, maybe third or fourth, we'll see, like on Zwift Power, I think it was third or fourth, but I just, when I went to hit the power up, I dropped about 2 meters back, and that cost me in the end. Cost me in the end, that, like, 2 meters. Because I didn't get the launch. I was actually in a perfect spot. And a deep, like, it wasn't a great sprint. But, I mean, I hit 780 or so. So, it's like 12.7, 12.8. I don't know, actually, what is that? That's, 13. So I hit 13 watts per kilo, but like it wasn't my best. I've done much better sprints than that. Like, I don't know, it was a weird sprint actually. Like I felt like I went like hard, but I didn't have the just bang. But the 3 meters, and I say that was a bit demoralizing. When I looked up after I finally found where my mouse was to hit the power up, lost 3 meters, and that lost my launch. Like I could have had a good launch pad there. And then zinged it quick. I think I could have, I actually could have taken Lionel there if I didn't lose. I think he won it, maybe. I don't know, we'll see on Zwift Power. But I mean, it was a good effort. That climb was awfully surgy. You saw it, it was like, you can see on the map there. Very surgy effort, kind of like 500 watts down to 300, 500, 300, but just disappointing on the sprint, just lost the wheel at the critical moment. Oh my god, throughout the whole thing I gotta figure this out, maybe I gotta get the Wahoo fan or something, I don't know, maybe 3 more fans. I'm just dying down here. That's second race in a row where I got a cramp in the calf, which was a problem, quite a problem on that second lap. It was just, felt pretty garbage. Like underneath me right now there's a lake. Anyways, curious to see what place I came. I don't know if I got on the podium. I think I was maybe fourth. Man, I just disappointed because I had a good position, like a really good position in the last kilometer. Like I was really happy with where I was in the group. And then just in a second, I just started 0.5 seconds late. Because I lost 3 meters trying to hit that power up. I guess I could have used a space bar. I think space bar is a power up. Damn, why didn't I do that? I'm just not used to doing that. But, that's silly. Why didn't I do that? Shit. Yeah, because... anyways. Shit. I actually do think if I was 3 meters ahead... because I was picking people off there. If I was 3 meters ahead, I would have had it. Because I lost by 0.2 seconds. Damn it. Let me load up this YouTube. I don't even know if we're on. Yeah, we are, I guess. Anyways. Let's see what we got. Thanks, everyone. It was okay. Wasn't good. Wasn't my best. Didn't have really... I mean, I don't know. That climb was not really... It's weird for me to say, like, oh, I don't think I had the upper end, but it was, my heart rate was insanely high all race, and that was, and it, like, the thing is that it felt high. Like, it wasn't like, sometimes you're just like, oh, I don't think the heart rate monitor is accurate. Here it was just like I feel kind of tight in my chest. First time kind of doing a race like that, coming right out of a recovery week. And definitely was a bit of a shock. Like, my heart rate was at, like, what was it, 190 plus the entire time up that climb. And it was kind of a different climb than, I mean, like, Box Hills type things. Like, the, once going up Box Hill, like, I'm just trying to hold 425, 430. But here it was like, we started and it was like 350 to stay in. And then 500, holy moly. That Oliveira guy, if he's for real, he was putting in like some big surges. Like, I'm really proud of one of the moves that I made on that climb. If I go back to the race, I was pretty far back in the group, and the Oliveira guy was off the front, and then Lionel hit the gas. It's Lionel Vuesen. He was like number one ranked Zwifter in the world. He's a professional Zwift racer. He hit the gas and bridged up to him. And I'm really happy with my move there to be able to get to them too. It was probably on the third to last turn or so. I'm not really familiar with the course, obviously. It's my first time riding it, but that was a really good, powerful hit, but it was just so hot down here. I felt like the entire time, like, it felt like I was breathing like this, like really shallow breaths, like not really getting good kind of airflow. And I think that's going to be a peak 60-minute heart rate on the year, for sure. I didn't see it under 170 the entire time. Which is pretty insane. But anyways, and then the sprint, I'm just upset at my thing, like, there. I lost, like, 3 meters at, like, a really important time, stupidly trying to hit the power-up. And the power-up, I actually don't know if I got to look back, because... It's my first time on the course. I didn't really know how to time the power-up perfectly. I hit it with maybe 200 to go after I finally found where I was hitting. By that point, it was just a little too late. I think if I had 100 more meters, 50 more, not even, 50 more meters, I think I would have come through like a rocket ship there. But, and it would have helped if I had, like, a big, big pop. But, I mean, I'm not going to get that because, like, the legs were pretty tired. Like, we haven't really recovered at all from the climb, so I'm not expecting, like, 900 watts here. Right? Anyways. That's all. So, time to get back to work. This was a good kick in the pants going I'm not sure I should have done this race, honestly. Like, I was thinking about doing it, thinking about not doing it. I was kind of half and half. Because that's like not the best way. I wanted to start a training block. But anyways, we'll see what the stats look like on some of those climbs. I don't even know what the time was. That was pretty quick. I think we averaged like 50 for the entire time, so that was fast. Anywho, thanks for watching, everyone. Yeah, Dean, I agree. That was pretty full gas, like, not full gas from the start, but I mean, like, the first lap, I think I averaged 300, and I didn't see the front of the group for the entire time, so it was like 5 watts per kilo, and that's with the descent in it, so I mean, it's moving. The second lap, it's interesting, I don't know if yours was like that too, but the second lap really was very different than the first. It was still quite steady. I finally kind of got into the pace there maybe halfway through that flat section, but it was taking about 260, 270, so like 4.5 or so just to kind of stay in. So, I mean, that's a pretty good pace for an hour. I don't know, like, what was last lap power? I don't know, I think the normalized on is going to be about 300 for 55 minutes. So, that's pretty good with a really surgy little climb there. Like, it was so funny. I thought, like, this was going to be, like, a peak 5-minute power test, basically. But that was so weird, like it was so different than what I expected. It was like literally surge, recover, surge, recover. So it's quite interesting. And I think that's just because it's so flat. Like, it's not like a crazy climb. It's not radio tower or anything where, yes, you can just sit at 7 and, or whatever, you know, sit in zone 5, whatever that is. And then, just pound there. This felt like I did that for a little bit on the first lap. I sat on the front for just a little while, probably 400 or so, but I wasn't really getting anywhere. I felt like I was shedding some people off, but what shed more people off was Voisin's and Oliveira's there, just big surges, and that's what really broke the group. Like, we really completely destroyed the group on that surge I was talking about from before. The three of us off the front. Maybe I should have taken over, but like, and tried to drive the pace, but Voisin is the bigger man there. So I mean, I think if he drove the pace, he would have maybe kept us away from the other group behind us. I don't know, it's a tough call. It's a tough call when you've never done the race before. You don't know, like, you look at it and you see like, okay, there's, you know, 2.5, 3K left. We're going down a hill, but it's not a really steep hill. And it's interesting because the super tuck was really dangerous to be in because, like, you, I saw Lionel, like, 2 or 3 times. He tried super tucking and almost got dropped because the hill just was so, it wasn't that steep. And then this Trek Madone bike that they have us on for the series is really, it's a slow bike. Like, I don't know why we're on it. It's a really slow bike. Like, I think today's time, whatever it was, the, you know, 48, 49K an hour, it's about 49K an hour. I think it would have been over 50 had we been on Tron bikes. Easily. And, I mean, I did make actually on the bike, I made a tactical move, and this might have been the difference, actually, in the end, thinking back on it. Like, that could have actually maybe got me the win. I still don't know what place I am. Let's see if I can find out before I turn this stream off. If I had the disc and the Super 9, or the 858 and Super 9 combo, I think I could have actually been I could have actually won that, potentially. Let me see if I can just get the results here. Because that, like, if you look at the zip compared to some of the other wheels and stuff like that, 0.2 seconds, Lionel was 0.2 seconds faster than me on the final sprint. It looks like, just based on the segment data that they had there at the end. And a disc and what's it called could have done it. Disc and whatever, 858 could have done it for sure, I think. That would have been a big, because I would have had a huge amount of speed coming down that. Damn! Another thing. Another mess up. I mean, I haven't raced this one before, so I'm not gonna, you know, shoot myself all day, but see what the results are just before you go. And then we have results. Next update in 6 minutes. So I'll get in 6 minutes, but I'm going to be getting off the bike before then. What the hell's going on? Anyways, so I'm not gonna wait 6 minutes, but I'll put the results when I get them in the description there. And as usual, thanks so much for watching. Really appreciate. If you hit that like button, it really helps the channel out and helps get these streams to more people. And yeah, again, appreciate watching. It's a pretty long race to hunker down and watch for, but appreciate it. So that's all for now, and I'll catch you later, maybe on Monday. What is Monday? Is Monday tomorrow? I don't know. Doing some interesting stuff this week. Anyways, alright.